Don't know why I act the way I do. Like I ain't got a single thing to lose. Sometimes I'm my own worst enemy. I guess that's just the cowboy in me.
Always seek adventure. Signing in. So if you guys ever wonder what, when I'm talking about a sous vide, this is a sous vide. See that? These steaks are sitting in here in a water bath in a bag, cooking at 120 degrees. They will be in there for 2 hours. I will then do a sear on them on a cast iron, let them rest for about 5 minutes, and down the hatch. Best way, in my eyes, in my book, to cook a steak now. You know, I used to be able to cook a really good steak. I still can, but this is the lazy way. But it's the perfect way. You never fuck up a steak. You put it at the proper temperature, these here will come out medium rare. So, we have been on a journey. A sourdough journey. So, this is what is called a sourdough starter. See how bubbly that is? This is a natural yeast. Natural occurring yeast. You just feed it. You just go for 7 days. You add water. You add flour. You mix it up. You let it sit. Next day, take some out. Add some more water and flour. Next day, you do that for a week. And eventually, you end up with a perfect yeast. And what does that make us? Well, here. Let me go in my fridge here. So, these are my wife's sourdough English muffins. They come out really fucking good. We are going to try making a sourdough loaf in this. But we have this pan. This guy right here. We put our loaf in there, right? And we put the lid on it. And that makes a perfect loaf of bread. And this is where that is. So, yeah. So that's really fucking cool. On the other note, other than sourdough stuff, we have acquired Easter eggers. If you want to know what an Easter egger is? This is regular brown egg from, you know, one of our regular chickens. That is an Easter egg. And, of course, they call it an Easter egg. And sometimes they lay one of those. It's really weird. You don't want to eat those. They're very sour. But this is an Easter egg. We bought four hens and one rooster. They're kind of beat up. But they're only a year and a half old, I think. They're just specific. So all five of them live together. That's it. Let me go take you out to them. So, you may recognize the coop. Back from Chicken Gate days, back in McMinnville. Yeah, I still have this thing. I had to do some rebuilding on it. Hey, ladies. I gotta put a piece of tin back here or something. No eggs right now. I was surprised they laid that one last night. But the coop is back together. It's doing its thing. Like I said, they do look rough, but the roo and the four hens, they're all the same breed. They're all Easter eggers. So, no eggs on the floor. Ow. But, oh well. You guys are fucking making a mess. I gotta get you water, don't I? Yep, gotta get you water. But, other than that, we're gonna start hatching them. We're gonna get, you know, about 30 or so eggs ready to go, and we're going to hatch them. So, aside from that, this is now the goat pen. That's just a table for them to jump around on, because goats love to jump on stuff. I did a lot of digging around in here. It's just, I'm done with worrying about the, they'll be fine. They live in, you know, rough conditions as it is. Well, not, I wouldn't say rough. This is the Taj Mahal compared to where they're at right now, because they just got a little bitty doghouse that they go into. They got all of this, so. But eventually, they will have all of that once I trust them enough. But I am going to, like I said before, putting a fence from there over to the fence over there, give them a little area. But let's go check out the birdos. Let's check out the rest of my birds. Hello, ladies and gents. They are using the box. Thank God. And they're using that. What the hell? So, they're still laying in the corner right there. No big deal. Just checking on you. Yeah, they're doing good. They all roost in here at night now, so that's good. We are getting our goats this week. I can go get them whenever I want, really. I just need to just go do it. Just go get them. Well, we need to get feed first, so we gotta get feed. So, once we get feed, we'll get them. But I do have my sister-in-law coming down Wednesday with her kids. And it'd be nice to have the goats for the kids to play with and check out. Yeah, bud. So, I got that here to keep the freaking big prey birds away from us. That seems to be working. They seem to not like that thing. Well, this is an update on the birds in the farm. Now let's update you on that thing there. That video is coming up next.